What's up guys, Matt from the Full Boots team, and today, thanks to the King of Knuckleballs Power and Precision, he's going to be teaching you and me how to master the knuckleball free kick made famous by CR7. Can his tips help us out? Let's find out.
So the knuckleball free kick is one of the most advanced techniques when it comes to shooting, and if performed correctly, it can have serious swerve and movement, making it a nightmare for goalkeepers. Gareth Bale, Cristiano Ronaldo and many other professionals have mastered the technique, but what makes it so special? Well, the knuckle or dead ball effect is achieved by getting as little spin on the ball as possible, and by doing this disables the aerodynamics being able to flow past the ball in an even way, which causes the unpredictable movement we so often see. So to learn the knuckleball free kick, there's going to be three main factors that you need to consider to achieve the perfect strike. Step one.
What part of the foot should I use? Most commonly, using the hardest bone in your foot, which sits across the laces and instep, is the best connection point for a knuckleball. You need to bend your foot and angle it about 45 degrees on striking the ball so you get a direct and clean hit.
So for the first step, like I mentioned in the video, I'm actually using the hardest bone of my foot, which is crossed between your laces and your instep. And this is genuine because it's a natural position for me, it's more comfortable. And if you want to copy my way, then I highly suggest you angle your foot 45 degrees outwards, and this way you're going to be getting a nice clean hit on the ball. But however, some of you might want to use a different technique. For example, Luke in Power and Precision, he's actually using the side of his foot. Now personally, I don't really think it matters about where you're kicking the ball, because it's more about the follow through and the contact area on the ball. So it's something that's comfortable for you, but if you do want to copy me and do my sort of technique, then it is going to be the hardest bone in your foot. For the benefit of this video, I will play a few more examples for you now so you can see in slow motion exactly where I'm connecting with.
Step 2.
Where should I be striking the ball? You need to kick the ball dead centre or slightly below in order to achieve a knuckleball free kick. Failing to do so will result in a curve, topspin or backspin effect, which will ruin the knuckleball.
For beginners, I suggest using the valve or a logo on the ball to mark this area out. This way, when approaching the ball, you know exactly where you need to try and kick. Pointing your toes can also help because it reduces your chances of getting underneath the ball and creating a backspin effect.
Right, so for step 2 of the knuckleball, it's actually going to be where you're contacting on the ball. Now, I said in the video you need to be striking dead centre in the ball or slightly underneath, and there is a reason for this, and that is because you don't want to get backspin, you don't really want to get topspin, and you definitely don't want to get side spin because that's going to create a curl effect. So the reason we want to kick the ball in the middle or in the centre is because that's sort of the sweet spot area for striking the ball, and it's going to take the spin out of the football, which means it will have that knuckle effect, unpredictability, and it will swerve a lot. So if you're going to be kicking the ball side on, it's obviously going to curl whichever way you're kicking it. If you're getting underneath it, it's going to get backspin and fly over. And you can kick it slightly over and it will get topspin. Might be used to get it up and down over a wall really quickly. Gareth Bale does that a lot more, whereas Ronaldo goes more for a dead ball effect, and that's when it just swerves, moves, and it's completely unpredictable. So again, I'm going to show you some more examples in slow motion of where I'm contacting the ball. But I like to use sometimes a logo or especially a valve to put it where I'm aiming to kick. And that way it's just easier when you're running up, you've got something to focus on and you know where to hit. Now, some people do say that kicking it on the valve gives you more shot power. I don't necessarily think that's the case. I honestly just use it because it's a good way of aiming where to kick the ball. But there is a slight durability issue with that, is it does actually kick the valve in. And a couple of my footballs, they have got damage because of that. So maybe I'd use a logo instead. But overall, it doesn't matter what part of the ball you're kicking, just as long as you're kicking in the centre.
Step 3. Finally, and most importantly, is the follow-through. Unlike a power strike or a curve free kick, you want to keep your follow-through minimal because this is how you actually take the spin out of the ball to create that knuckle effect.
To do so, you need to use the momentum from striking the ball to plant your shooting foot into the ground straight away. I tend to bring my foot across my body before planting it, which is more comfortable and natural for me. I imagine it being like a quick punch of the ball, and if you follow these three steps correctly, you should end up with a solid knuckleball technique.
So, I'm going to show you some more examples in slow motion from different angles, and honestly, this step is the most important because this is what takes the spin out of the ball as well as kicking it in the right place. But honestly, with the follow through, it takes a lot of practice. You've got to be committed. I mean, I think it took me at least 6 months to start getting a tiny bit of consistency. I'm 2 and a bit years down the line now, and I'd like to think I'm pretty consistent, which is why we do our unedited free kick sessions. So honestly, the main thing you can do is just practice. You've got to be consistent. You've got to be committed to doing, committed to trying. And it can be quite difficult, especially if you're used to curving the ball or just shooting normally. It's really, really hard to get used to. But trust me, once you do, it's a lot easier and it will get better from there.
But now it's time for the challenge. And we've got 5 of the best knuckleballers in the world going head to head. And once you've seen all of them, you guys get to vote who you think's the winner by voting in the poll card. So guys, there it is, power and precision's tips and tricks to improve your knuckleball technique. In the poll card, what we want to know is, do you prefer the knuckleball technique or the old school whippage? Vote in the poll card now, but that's it guys, thanks for watching, cheers.